guys, Crew Blonde Wave back. I'm Aaron.
I'm Cal.
Rick.
Eric.
And we are the boys. Or we're back with the boys. Something like that, right?
Daddy's home.
We are. Previously, we killed a whale. Yeah. Also, Calvin's back.
Yep. And the mouse.
For those that didn't know, Calvin immediately was like, I hate the boys. I'm not watching. Left.
We convinced him to come back.
Now he's back. No, right, Calvin?
That did not happen at all.
No. He was terribly sick.
Violently ill.
We're so insensitive. So yeah, Calvin, the rest of the episode, how did you feel about it?
It went about the way I expected it to.
Yeah.
Until the whale.
Until the whale. Yes.
Which then, wasn't very far.
Yeah. And then everything changed.
Yeah.
When the whale attacked.
We had Starlight being maybe forced to kill Huey.
Yeah.
Do you think she was going to do it?
I think she was going to turn on Homelander and it wouldn't have gone well.
Really?
Yeah.
I think she might have killed Huey.
Instead, Butcher sent out his newest soup friend, who then fought Homelander and then was killed by Stormfront.
Yep.
Yeah, did you expect her turn?
Turns out?
I liked her too much.
She didn't really have... I don't know if I want to call it a turn, because I wasn't like... Oh, I feel like she's a good person right away anyway. Like,
she wasn't exactly out there kissing babies.
She wasn't.
And yeah, but Homelander does.
Then she also killed all the black people she could see and then called that dude yellow. So who would have thought that someone named Stormfront is racist? I didn't make that connection at all until people mentioned it. Stormfront is the first like white supremacy forum on the internet.
Name
Stormfront. So, okay.
Why would I know that?
I've heard about it, but I didn't make the connection until after. So,
right,
I'm like, okay, well, yeah, it's
no,
in,
I've never heard
it's
of that.
In the name.
Yeah, that's
that works.
That makes sense.
Yeah,
that's crazy. I wonder.
All right, so we had a poll last time. I should say that before I actually start looking at the poll. The poll last time was, and Calvin will get your input. Which character do you hate the most right now? Homelander or Stormfront? Calvin, go!
I'm gonna say Stormfront.
Stormfront, you hate Stormfront more?
More right now. Yeah.
Well, you're gonna have 75% support in our poll.
Wow.
25% saying Homelander.
They're both awful.
They're both pretty awful.
I'm hoping they get at odds of each other and fight each other.
Fred Yoop says, I can excuse narcissism. But I draw the line at white supremacy. Yeah, I get you. Well, I said Homelander last time just because I know of a lot more that Homelander has done bad. Like,
you know, so many more murders.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
We know of.
Like, when Maeve wanted to, at least let's save these two kids from the plane. He's like, what? No, you idiot. Let's go.
Yeah, they gotta all die.
Yeah.
I mean, that doesn't make any sense.
That was pretty, that filled me with some hate there. But
well,
the actors are so good, but both the actors are so good because I immediately was like, Stormfront, I like her, you know?
She makes you want to like her. She's like the person who's been in it for a while. She knows how to game the system, and she's not putting up with anyone's bullshit.
Is Stormfront, I don't know because we haven't gotten too far and too much information with her. Maybe we will this time. Like, is there a line of racism to white supremacy? Like, are they the same?
I mean, anyone can be racist.
You don't have to be a white supremacist necessarily, but she might be.
Yeah.
Right? Is that the idea?
I mean...
Of course, some of these people might know stuff from comic books, maybe.
Not all racists are white supremacists, but all white supremacists are racist.
Yeah, it has to be that way, right? Yeah.
It's a...
I'm just wondering if,
it's
like...
wider racism.
Yeah. I'm just wondering, like as we learn more about her, we learn that she is a white supremacist, and people are like, well, that's why she has this name.
Yeah.
And from the comic books, we already know this kind of stuff,
sure.
too. Because I know there's the boys' comics out there, too.
Yeah.
Or is she just, like, a... I don't know how she
is.
Right now, she's not at the top of my list.
No, I do. I understand.
I'd rather work with, like, A-Train and Black Noir.
Like, I mean, Homelander is clearly also racist in the way that he, like, treats, like, America versus the rest of the world.
Well, he had the line.
Way he looks. But we should also say that he sees everybody equally as below him. He's Homelander supremacist.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
But he had, like, the line... He has, like, an American thing. Like, he's like, you should speak American.
Yeah.
And he has, like, speaking of Spanish at the breakfast table and stuff that he, like, looked down on. So he has, like, that American kind of thing, but it is kind of a racist, but also a... Yeah, he's above everybody regardless of who you are or what you are or whatever, so...
Lumpa Waru. Great name.
Good
Okay. Says, Homelander is too frightening to hate. You hold your breath when he's on screen, which speaks to how good the actor is. I do feel, like, really tense and not like this fucking guy sometimes, so I get
Although,
that.
Although, his cape was rumpled last episode.
It was rumpled. I love when he, like, does that, like, cape thing around his arm. He's just so good at it.
The only time I don't feel scared is when he's with Stan Edgar. Then I feel scared for Homelander.
That's the thing to think about. If Edgar is smart and knows everything about the person he brought in the Seven, then he brought a known racist. And, you know?
Yeah.
And he's being, you know, as a black man, you know?
So the one
he
thing...
He probably just doesn't give a shit.
The one thing I'm wondering is, shoot, damn it. Duh, fuck it, Eric.
Yeah.
Nothing. You fucking kept talking, I forgot what I was saying.
No. Ray refuses to enter in this poll. He says, I hate them both equally. They're both fascist, racist, narcissistic, murderous pieces of shit. So he doesn't feel very strongly about either of them.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, she did the same thing Homelander did with, like, going in there. She just killed everyone, didn't, you know, just killed them all, destroyed the building, and then they blamed that guy.
And some people were like, where's Hunter Hunter? I slept in on Saturday morning. I'm sorry. And then there's just a lot of essays. One of the cool things about being a patron over at patreon.com/blindwave is you get to read all the comments and interact over there as well. So anyway, most people said that they hate right now Stormfront, but you know, we'll see. We all feel a little close to Homelander, so maybe there's a little bit of affection in how much we know him.
I don't think that's how it works.
I enjoy his performance.
Rick?
He maybe redeems himself?
No.
For his son?
No. Yeah.
There you are.
Hmm? Huh?
I was beginning to worry.
Wait, is that still?
Yeah.
I thought she was...
What?
I'm thirsty.
Is that milk?
Yep.
Yes.
Man, this show is really trying hard to make me not want milk.
It's not good for you.
No,
it's
failing. Why don't you go buy some? Buy some milk, Eric. Look what you can do.
Got milk, Homelander.
Yeah. Like, Jansy, get some milk. Where are we? What is this cabin place? What? What?
I don't know.
Mallory. I found Becca.
What? His wife?
Or at least our best guess where she is. Mod facility, armed to the teeth. Won't be easy.
What if this is the dude
doppelganger
that changes people's faces?
I wrote down my theory. I think it could be that. Or doppelganger is the one that died. Okay, it's doppelganger.
Change back! I'm sorry! I can only hold a shape for so long, it really hurts!
That makes more sense now.
Damn. This is weird.
Come here. Oh, my little boy. Come on.
Oh, my God.
Is he doing this so he doesn't die?
It's okay.
Is he a prisoner?
Probably.
No more lies.
Oh, fuck.
Am I lying?
Technically, all those things were true. Ugh. So tense.
Because he can hear like the heartbeat and all that stuff, right?
Oh yeah. He can like see the blood pressure and shit.
Yeah.
Is he going to steal our Mel's bar?
Oh. That's an almond joy.
Is it?
Yep.
Would you like an almond joy?
Mel's is superior. No! It's also in a red wrapper.
Or you can join me.
He's so funny.
The way he wrote Butcher 2 was so like scribbly.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wasn't it?
There it is. Yeah.
Oh, these two. Look how cute they are.
Hey, this ain't a little Vegas road trip. Not a date either. Chill. Not your goddamn chaperone.
I love Evan.
Oh my god. Look at the cape. Set them free. But what is up with this?
That seems crazy to me because
Baskin Robbins. Every Sunday after church. My pops, he'd always ask for samples. Now, this place had 31 flavors, and that man would taste each and every flavor every time we'd go up in there. We'd be aligned all the way out the door. People would be mad as hell. Of course, now I'd give a year off my life just to be able to see that man going through spoon after spoon, just one last time. To Fathers and Sugar.
Oh, what a great scene.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
It's wonderful to be a member of the boys now.
Whoa. All over your skin, here.
He's a wet wipe.
Got to use wet wipes, then.
Mother's milk.
Carry these around with you?
Damn right.
Oh, fuck! What happened?
Car just pulled out in front of that truck.
Did someone see Starlight?
Can't help.
No.
Oh, we can't help.
Can't help.
No. Okay, that guy, he's calling 911. He'll be okay.
Okay, I thought the truck driver like saw Starlight and was like looking.
What?
Yeah, that happens.
I saw that car pulling so slowly out in front. I was like, man, they better pull out quicker.
They generally don't do that for continuity reasons.
Yeah.
In shows.
Any place around here without a million bloody cameras?
Man, he works fast.
Yep. He hopped over that wall like nothing.
I said if he hurt you, I would kill myself in front of Ryan.
Damn.
And my last words would be your father did this to me.
Damn.
Okay.
I don't know how he's gonna handle Ryan.
Oh my god!
Threw away half her candy bar.
It's harder than it looks. I think, you know, actually, I think I went.
Like, my last boyfriend was obsessed with Ed Sheeran.
I'm not sure what this is.
Yeah, it's gonna come together.
So he asked me to get one of these with him.
An Ed Sheeran death?
Oh my god. That's not
later,
a great
he
death.
Broke up with me.
What?
I fucking hate Ed Sheeran.
Wow. I need to find out what those are.
What?
Those cutaways.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I just don't quite know what they are.
But check your facts. Let's take the 7, for example. We've got A-Train. He's a black man. We've got Black Noir.
Is Black Noir black?
We don't identify with any race, really.
So. Okay.
And
they're covered.
We have a gay hero.
Really?
Oh, fuck.
Oh.
He's about to out-mave.
I'm Huey. Is there by any chance a woman living here who used to go by the name of, Liberty?
Liberty.
No.
Liberty. I think there is.
Okay, we have the red address, right?
What's the trouble, ma'am?
Get out! Your car was involved in a robbery tonight. Just confess.
Why are you doing this to me, lady? Ain't you supposed to be a hero?
I am a hero for killing a black piece of shit like you.
Jesus!
Fuck.
Jesus.
Oh, why don't you go to the police? Right here. That's her. Right there. That's Liberty.
What?
Oh.
Did she not age?
Valerie was just a little girl, and she said it was raining, so she could be wrong.
Oh my god, he's looking at memes.
Oh my gosh, these would infuriate him.
With a clicker.
That one's the best.
Oh my gosh.
What path that you're on? It started so long before me. I can't.
Every guard in this goddamn place is gonna be here in 60 seconds.
Oh, damn.
She's calling them.
I have to go. I'm sorry.
Take down Vought.
I'm so sorry.
That's a lot of Red Bull.
Red Bull. Is he still sitting there?
Of course he is. Ah, shit.
Oh, shit.
Ah, shit. Oh, shit.
You mean hide it?
That's him leaving, right?
Mm-hmm.
And who the fuck is this person? You know the one thing about him?
Small
like, it could just be anybody.
I know.
You know?
Yeah.
Could be invisible.
It could be invisible. Could be man, girl.
I'm a feminist. But I'm also very sexual.
She was like, hands down the winner. It was not even a contest.
It's Cassandra.
Just to get Sharon one?
The one with the hair and the creepy skeletons hugging each other's story?
Oh,
yes,
that one.
That's your wife.
Wife?
Oh.
Glass
kill,
of milk.
Gonna kill her again.
The glass of milk.
I don't need anyone.
Oh, it might be worse.
But myself.
Oh.
This got a little weird.
Didn't change the outfit, though.
Like what you see?
No.
See how hot you are?
This poor guy's trying to keep himself alive.
This is the ultimate form of narcissism.
We're not doing this, are we?
I think we are.
It's not even gay.
It's like masturbation.
Like a weird masturbation technique.
Strange.
Man, this guy reads people very well. This is a hell of a gamble.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. Maybe he doesn't read very well.
Oh, it's not gonna work. Okay. He's gonna kill him.
Oh.
Yeah.
He's gonna kill him.
I don't need you.
Oh.
Man, doppelganger could have been useful.
Could have been.
He was. I guess.
Killed the old weak version of himself.
Man, what's worse, killing yourself or sucking yourself? Man, what a hell of a scene.
That was an episode.
You know, it was. It was like a, we kind of need to, I feel like it needed to like kind of calm down and have like a reset episode a little bit after this first three, because those were pretty crazy. But I mean, in the boys' fashion, they're like, you know, take a back seat episode is still just as crazy. Man, that actor is so good. Guy plays Homelander. He's so fucking good. Everybody talks about that Banshee show he's in.
Yeah.
If you want to watch it.
Yeah. No. Yeah. No, I love his scenes. I was very confused at first when Stillwell was there.
Yeah.
And I was
yeah.
Like,
what? Like at first, I thought it was like a flashback or
yeah.
something.
Milk in a cabin? What the fuck are we doing?
Yeah.
Did he sneak her out somehow?
Well, I was like, how could she be 11? We saw her inside of her head. You know?
Yeah.
So,
we saw through her head.
Went to the second scene, I was like, there's a doppelganger guy. We haven't
yeah.
seen him in forever. Where's he been?
Well, at first I wrote I guess we know one person. There's the doppelganger guy. And then I was thinking, wait, holy shit. What if Stillwell, who used doppelganger in the past, somehow used doppelganger, and he was the one that died? And she's alive. But I'm like, but she would not be doing this, you know, if that was the case. So... Went a little too deep on that one.
That and the interviews confused me equally.
Yeah, it makes sense
yeah.
now, though, because that's
yeah.
a very much a rumored, alleged thing that Scientology does.
Yeah. No, every time it cut away, I'm like, I don't know how this is connecting in or what this is for or anything. And I don't know how it's going to work out for the deep, but they're picking a wife. He hasn't been kicked out of the seven yet, but they're kicking A-Train out.
Well, what about A-Train? Because he had to... Now he's like their diversity guy, you know?
Well,
can he not get rid of him now?
They should.
They said like he's going to have like a year of parades and talk show circuits and stuff
yeah.
like that.
Yeah, that's
I think it's a transition rather than
that's
he's out now.
Yeah.
I was going to say that's because he's gone. Once he's gone, and it's like, oh, you know, we're going to miss him and da da da. So.
But maybe not, because now Homelander doesn't care if people love him. Maybe. So maybe he just doesn't care. I mean, if Stormfront is a white premises,
mm-hmm.
like maybe she pushes Homelander to get rid of him that way somehow.
And she has been for 70 years when she was Liberty.
Yeah, that's an interesting
that's
thing.
That's a hell of a thing.
That's just part of her power base is like maybe she doesn't age or something.
Yeah, I mean, well, they said well, like the founder.
70 years? I thought it was 48 years ago.
48. They said that she would have been 70.
Yeah.
Like she'd be like 70, you know?
Well, and she was a second tier hero back then.
Yeah.
So did her powers change? Did they evolve? Did she take more Compound B?
I mean, we never knew anything about Liberty, if she had any kind of lightning ability or
Liberty,
fly,
we didn't
or...
see any powers at all with what they showed us so far.
Just saw super strength.
Just super strength, but they all kind of have that.
Or is
a couple
it
of them do.
Liberty's daughter?
We need a...
The daughter is more powerful than the parent, and we'll see that with Homelander's son as well.
We need to go back and look at that Liberty, like, magazine thing and see if it has, like, does it look like Stormfront at all?
Well, I feel like they would have recognized it was Stormfront.
She had a mask, right?
Yeah.
Well, the picture they saw
the
was like a
hood, right?
Was like a painting, wasn't it? It wasn't like a photograph, I thought. I thought it was like a stylized, like...
Are you telling me a painting of George
like
Washington looks nothing like George Washington?
No, I don't know. I mean, she has a hood up. You know, she can change.
A painting.
You
can't believe those.
I don't know. I feel like they're implying it's her because she has that line in the Homelander scene at the end when she's like, you know, I learned to change.
Yeah.
Implying that, like, she was this and now she's doing this thing, you know?
Yeah.
But still with the same goal of, like, controlling people. It's like, I'll have this demographic, you got this demographic, but we're all doing the same shit, you know?
Yeah. I was just saying, like, maybe if we looked at it, we'd be like, man, now I see similarities I didn't realize that were there, kind of thing. But
I don't know where it would be.
So how long has Vought
like, the very beginning
been doing this?
Well, the creator, the Mr. Vought or whatever, he was a Nazi in
right.
the 40s, right?
That's true.
Yeah.
And they brought him over like they did the Nazi rocket scientists.
He was working with the Nazis.
Was he from...
he got...
Was Argentina?
He got, like, captured and brought over and was used for U.S. stuff because of his knowledge of, like, the Compound V kind of stuff and whatnot.
Our newest hero is going. The
maybe they don't. I swore they had it in the very beginning here. And that's the last part, so I guess they don't. It must just be whenever she hands it off and over to... when he gives it to Milk, right?
Yeah.
Or whenever... Whenever he gives it to Milk or whenever she gives it to Butcher. There's a thing in there.
Yeah,
I don't know. I'm just curious on, like, if there's similarities between, like, the way they look.
I mean, just that they're both women is all it looks like to me. I mean, there wasn't any kind of, like... lightning effect or
I'm not looking at power that. Bases because we didn't see anything before.
I mean she has a hood up and like a
dominant color,
mask
what color's her hair or like is her face look similar or can she change what she actually looks like
I mean,
too kind of like Doppelganger has or is
yeah.
there
I mean
no.
she can change her hair to look like
yeah you
whatever.
Can dye your hair you can I mean she has it shaved on one side and she has the hood up
no one recognizes Superman he's gonna wear a mask
yep
you do. You're reading the comic, you see, look, it looks the fucking same, you can see, look, I draw all these little things, I figured
like,
it out.
This guy?
Yeah, but you're outside the story, you're told
yeah,
that
we're outside this story too, Cal, that's what I'm saying. That's my point. I just wanted to look and see. I'm the fool for thinking that we can look at a secret identity and figure out who they are. The best secret identity is whoever the hell Black Noir is, because the more I think about, like, him getting blown up, and then, like, just being fine, and then just showing up here, not talking at all. I'm like, and then Homelander too. He's like, yeah, we got Black Noir, and he doesn't something.
Yeah.
You know, like he doesn't even know who he is. His best secret identity is whoever he really is.
Yeah, he's the seven version of Batman. You know,
yeah.
But that's
kinda.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you can still see Batman's like white skin.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like
you know?
With Black Noir, we know nothing about the person, and it's just. It's crazy to think about, like...
He could be a robot in there.
Yeah. Like, in a scene, he could walk by and we wouldn't know it. Or Black Noir could be freaking... No, it can't be Edgar, because Black Noir was there when Edgar...
He can't be a robot,
or it could have been a stand-in, Aaron. I was thinking about that, too.
I don't know.
He can't be a robot. He wouldn't be able to be a robot, because he feels such great emotion. But we saw his, like,
he was,
blood.
Like, crying, right?
Well, he, like... When he got blown up, he was, like, burnt and bloody.
I mean,
well,
the Terminator bled.
Sure.
But the Terminator didn't cry.
When he found out about... Vought, like he was distraught, but
yeah.
You know, he could feel emotions. Androids can feel emotions.
No, I've watched a Terminator.
He's not an android.
Why do you cry? Oh, man.
The scene with Homelander and Starlight, like, I'm like, it's crazy because, like, she's right with, like, her knot in her stomach, like, walking around, and, like, any moment she could.
That was a
find Homelander and Homelander would want to kill it, you know?
He does that a lot, just putting his hand on people's throats and like putting his thumb over right here. And all he likes to do is push, but here he did like on her side.
Yeah.
Like this is his finger. He's so goddamn threatening.
I feel like everyone who knows what Homelander really is feels that all the time.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That he could just
He could make his coffee wrong and
even,
he could just fucking kill you.
Even Stormfront there seemed to show a little fear whenever he started.
Well, yeah, the doctor that created him said, like, you were my greatest mistake, and then they took his son, and they're doing this with it, you know?
Yeah.
It's like living in the Old Testament, where God just smite you at any time, for any reason.
Yeah.
In a number of ways.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. But no, yeah.
But it's always because he's pissed off at you.
You're right with the difference. Like,
yep, sorry.
Homelander didn't have any kind of real upbringing. He was brought up as a superhero, as strong as he is, and
he
everything.
Was brought up as a science
but if you bring up his son as like an actual kid who cares about stuff,
yeah.
and people, and things, like maybe he can be the anti-Homelander. You know, like he can be the hero that Homelander should have been.
Mm-hmm.
But
so we already had Brightburn. We might get Superman.
Work for the Antichrist and Good Omens.
I don't know. Homelander still isn't Brightburn, in my opinion. I'm not sure exactly what Brightburn's after. I think he's a kid. At one point, he's just having fun. Like, could you imagine if Homelander as a kid was doing that shit? Like, he obviously wasn't.
Brightburn is he's pretty much a Saiyan. He's like, he was like coded to kill everything, you know, and then seeded. Whereas like Homelander, he's the soup they use to sell all their shit. You know, he's a commodity.
Well, what's so scary now is I think the reason Homelander, at least on the outside, appears to be this good hero and doesn't just go overboard is because he wants people to love him. But now if that's no longer the case and he doesn't care what people
think,
true. That is going to be terrifying.
Yeah. Now you start getting the Brightburn side of things, I think, where like he's... The line Stormfront had where it's like, you have fans, I have soldiers.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the people, when they're pissed off, they start doing the stuff, and...
Yeah.
She's talking about, like, you know, you need people to fear. Like, Homelander can make people fear.
Yeah.
Which, if it fits in that she's, like, a white supremacist racist kind of thing, and starts pushing her people towards, like, stuff like that, like, I don't know. I'm not sure what Stormfront... I still am not 100% sure what Stormfront is after... And if it's in Vought's best interest, because half the time it seems like it's not.
I mean, I think that she's doing exactly what Edgar wants her to do, which is I need you to come in here and capture this side of the audience. Homelander can have this side of the audience. And then we, you know, it's like what politics do. We divide and make them fight each other. And then you don't think about this other shit, you know? I think that's what they're doing. And with her saying, like, you know, like she has her own beliefs, but I think she's just riding the company line, which what she's doing is exactly, I think, what Vought wants her to do. You know, like to take control of, you know, make her the figurehead of all the people that hate what Vought is doing. Then they control that side as well. You know.
Yeah, because she's still contracted with Vought.
Yeah,
maybe. Yeah,
it's like, I mean, Edgar brought her here to do this.
I think he would have signed with them.
Edgar would have vetted the person that he brought in for Seven. You know,
it seems so weird. Like if you would have like Coca-Cola or Disney or something like that, and you have some kind of face of that company. But the whole time they're just dissing the company, talking about how terrible they are and how they don't care about. They want you guys to, you know, they have their American ads and they want you to feel safe and buy their shit and watch their movies.
Well,
it
would be as if Coca-Cola, like, oh yeah, fuck, we put a poison in there. All right, now everybody's gonna be pissed off about the poison we have in Coke. So they set up the person that is leading everybody that's pissed about the poison in Coke, and then they can have some kind of control over the opposition. You know,
they can guide the dialogue.
Yeah. I mean, it's the fucking same thing Papa did with Dooku.
Yeah, but all she's doing is pushing people against Vought.
Yeah, but, I mean, that was going to happen anyway because of the Compound V coming out. Like, the reason this happened was because Compound V got out there. So, like, all right. And then Edgar's sitting there, what the fuck do I do? And they're like, we need an answer. He's like, got it.
Yeah.
We're going to set up a fucking patsy leader of the opposition and get the control back.
Yeah, but then why do you have them under Vought?
What do you mean?
Like... Palpatine didn't have, like, they weren't members of the council that were running the other side. They were separatists that left, and they formed a new group.
Yeah.
Why have people in your group where they're like, look, they're Vought. Oh, they hate Vought. You know, it doesn't seem to really...
I would imagine so that, you know, because that
and
she's, like, contracted under
anyway.
The seven of the Vought,
then they
can just see where the wind goes, and they have, like, control of both sides.
He also already had an answer anyway of, we didn't know Stillwell's the one who did this. They implemented that. And
I mean,
there's our scapegoat.
That's their public.
We're safe and clear on everything we got to worry about.
I mean, I think that's their public stance, but I think their actual stance is to control both sides of the narrative.
I just feel like having someone in Vought controlling it is weird.
Also,
would you rather
have
them in
Vought
but make a new
group?
But if you were Vought, wouldn't you want to be able to control that other side?
Have them as Vought, but not in Vought. It seems backwards. Like,
yeah.
If Coca-Cola's like, all right, here's our new spokesperson, mm-hmm. but that person's talking shit about Coca-Cola, then I would think the way you're thinking. Like, why the hell are they in Coca-Cola? Why isn't Coca-Cola kicking them out? Like,
I mean,
why is she still in Vought in the Seven?
It kind of does that reverse psychology thing where it's like, hey, this person has something to lose, but their moral aptitude says that they need to do this, you know? And it gives them almost more credibility because they wouldn't be the right person to do it.
Something just seems weird.
Like a whistleblower.
Yeah.
It's like the whistleblower from Vought is saying this stuff.
Yeah, but you know how many whistleblowers?
Which gives them more credibility.
They fucking kick them out and they do shit, they sue them or whatever else. They're not doing nothing to her. That's the problem. That's what I don't like. If Vought was attacking her back, and maybe
yeah.
that's what happens later on, is Vought like gets rid of her out of the Seven.
Sure.
And now they're like, oh, look, now we can kind of control the narrative because we're still working with her.
Mm-hmm.
Then maybe it'd kind of work. But as of right now, it just seems so weird to have her in Vought talking shit about Vought.
Sure. I mean, I don't see that, but I don't know. It makes sense to me.
It'd be like if we had like Calvin just
yeah.
in Blind Wave talking shit about Blind Wave all the time and how
yeah.
terrible Blind Wave is or something like that. Then why are you in Blind Wave?
Well, then
leave.
Then you can fucking tell us whenever they're saying shit.
Get out of here.
And get ahead of it.
Yeah, but I would be leading that charge. I would be saying the shit.
Yeah.
Exactly. Like you're just making shit up, saying all this shit. Like,
well,
get rid of it.
I feel like the best way to look at it is politics.
Mm-hmm.
And like
yeah.
the same companies that own the extreme radio stations for either side.
Yeah.
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 It's like they want all this arguing and they want all
exactly.
this conflict.
True. It's
but,
exactly
but,
like when, exactly what you said is the radio stations who own it for either side, right?
Yeah.
It's a Democratic radio station or a Republican
well,
radio
no,
station,
like,
right?
No, like there's a umbrella company that owns both radio stations
mm-hmm.
that are just extreme on both sides, but it's not clear to the public maybe that the company owns both of them.
Yeah, and
yeah.
you sell to both groups.
Yeah, but that you also have like here's a radio station for Republicans, here's a radio station for Democrats. You don't have the Democratic radio station talking shit about the other Democrat stuff usually. You have them talking shit about the Republicans.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have a second group here. That's the weird thing. If you had Vought and not,
there's a certain
and then groups
group.
Did not
They're
are
inside.
Talking shit about Vought.
Yeah.
It's just like the NWO.
But Vought secretly owns not.
They were all owned by WCW, but they were an outside group.
See, yeah, but that works because you have another group. There is no other group. You just have WCW, whatever.
I get what you mean. I just don't think that's unrealistic to what could actually happen.
When has it ever happened?
I don't know.
That's
I'm
why
just
I
saying, I'm examining this thing and being like, oh, yeah, that I think that makes sense.
If I was Vought and she was talking shit, I'd kick her out of the Seven. She wouldn't be allowed in there anymore because she's talking shit about Vought.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that also, if you're wanting her to be on your payroll and push it, it makes more sense for them to be against Vought
mm-hmm.
and you're pushing the narrative because Vought, the bad guys, kicked her out.
I guess
no.
the way
and
I
then it works.
I understand what you mean. I just don't agree.
You don't agree that would work better?
No. I actually think this one is smarter.
Why is it smarter?
Because, like I said, like I think that there's something to a person that has something to lose. Doing this kind of stuff lends more credibility
yeah.
in the mind of the public.
Yeah,
so it
I
makes
agree.
Sense to have
I agree.
That are Vought.
Kicking her out, though, makes it seem that she's really being serious of what she's saying to Vought.
I don't necessarily agree with that.
So Vought just lets it happen?
Yeah.
Doesn't that seem shady as hell?
No, because they control the information, Aaron.
But
they control the media, the information,
no.
and all the anti-sentiment.
So as an outside person,
uh-huh.
I don't listen to her anymore because Vought must be okay with what she's saying because they aren't taking action against her.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So these people are stupid for listening to her. That's what I'm saying.
I don't think so. I do not agree.
Well, they are because she's a racist. They shouldn't be listening to her.
Yes, that I
can't believe you don't agree.
I agree with that. How are you defending racism? Now, okay, we have a spirited debate about this, but another thing that there was a lot of debate about was Becca raped seemed to be answered here.
Yeah,
with her saying like
he
raped me.
Yeah, she just said.
And you know, on like I've seen people go back and forth on this issue, and the biggest piece of evidence I always thought that she wasn't raped is that Homelander didn't say he raped her, and I think that if he did, he wouldn't care if he did or not. Like, but I think that he's such a fucking narcissist that he rapes her and doesn't think he is because every woman would want to be with me, you know? So that was always my counter to that piece of evidence.
I kind of, that got answered for me last episode when
mm-hmm.
he grabbed her arm and said, I gave you a son.
Oh, yeah, no, I get you. Yeah, I mean, I've always been on the side that I think that he raped her. But here, I mean, unless you say it's unreliable narrator, like, she straight up said it.
Yeah. I mean, the other side of that can be, like even though maybe it didn't seem like it, someone like Homelander, who, yeah. you know, him standing there, just talking to Starlight and not even, like, touching her yet.
Yeah.
So intense that it can be intimidating and she could do something that she wouldn't want to do necessarily.
Well, exactly.
You know?
It's like, say
no to
this
person. And the way that he's, like, there, it's like having a gun, but he doesn't have a gun, you know? Like, and
she has a gun.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it'd be like if you had a gun on your hip, but someone's worried about it, so they're just going with it because, like, oh man, he has a gun, he could do anything, you know? Like, so it easily could be that where, like, she went along with it, but she didn't want to because of who he was and how intimidating and scared she was, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it's the extreme example of, like, systemic power that a boss has over an employee. You know?
Yeah.
You say no, you might lose your job and get fired.
You don't get fired or something like that.
Except the Superman will kill you.
Yeah. Even if there's no, like fight element or something like that or struggle with it, it doesn't have to be.
And I think it makes perfect sense with her knowing who Butcher really is. If she said anything to him, she knows that it would have all consumed rage, revenge, so she doesn't say anything, and then she's pregnant. What the fuck do I do? So she goes and she sits on that bench for, 6 hours? That he saw, and then just went to VOD.
That was her deciding what she did.
Yeah.
She decided to go to VOD instead of Billy.
It's her making her decision of, like, if I go to Billy, what kind of path does it set him on? But when she didn't, what kind of path did that set him on, too?
I guess it was the same basic outcome.
I guess she thought that it was a safer option, and maybe he wouldn't go that route. But then you had, I think it's Mallory, who, like, put him on the path of Homelander did this, you know?
Yeah.
Well, or maybe once she went down the VOD route, I don't think she was offered a lot of choices either.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, but that was before that. Like, she had to make that decision of what she was going to do, you know? Was she going to tell Billy anything? Was she not?
Sure, but she didn't exactly know what VOD was going to do at that point either.
Sure, but there's also the idea of, do I tell Billy or not?
Yeah.
And when she chooses not to tell Billy, she thinks that that's the better route for Billy rather than to go tell him and then, look, here's what happened, and now he's after Homelander, which was a dangerous situation.
You know?
She knew how dangerous he was, so.
She chose not to go with him.
Yep.
She knew that he didn't
value
her son.
Yeah. Comes down to Ryan there. I still think that Ryan could be a good person, hero kind of thing.
I think he could be, too.
But she's not raising him to know his powers, so.
Do you think Billy will ever change his tune when it comes to Supes and to Ryan?
I mean, the thing is that it's very much like a Severus Snape situation where it's like, okay, this is the kid of the person you love. Okay, that's a plus. It's also the kid of the person you absolutely hate. All right, that's a negative. And it's added on, it's a soup, another negative, you know? So I could see him going one way or the other, but it feels like there's more negatives on his
side. And he does have a good point in that they'll never stop looking for him.
No.
Yeah. So, like, maybe he and Becca could get away and hide, but they're not hiding with him.
If they just took off and he was here, they'd probably deal with the kid and they'd let Billy and her go, you know? But
if there's no Vought, there's no one chasing him because no one knows about it. So maybe that's the next motivation. And it's the same thing for Huey with Starlight. They can't be together. But if there's no Vought, there's nothing to do that.
It's a big ask, though.
Oh, yeah. It's a big ask. But that's been what they wanted to do.
And they already attempted it before. Mm-hmm. Like Huey said, it can take time. But they've already started maybe some of it with letting the Compound V be out there and known.
Yeah.
And then, you know, they have protests happening. And, you know, they show the Middle East with protests. I imagine there's some protests in other places, too. There was
imagine the anarchy in the world if you knew that people could make superheroes and that they were, like, picking and choosing. And, like, they were picking and choosing 92% white people, you know? Like,
It's like representation at that point.
You would have so many protests and riots in America. You would have wars from outside America because everyone else would, like, well, we need more Russian superheroes because we need to be able to defend against American homeland.
NATO would get involved. United Nations.
I feel like the world would just be on fire.
So what they'll probably do is they'll be like, alright, well, who gets to decide? And everybody's like, well, Stormfront seems to know what she's doing.
Rick, like what you said there, it's probably the reason why they also had the Billy Joel song in there. You know? Yeah. Like, things are already starting to burn and go crazy and whatnot.
Well, and that could be why there were riots in Afghanistan.
Yeah. And it's not, you know, it's not Huey's fault and it's not Starlight's fault or anything, but, you know, they're trying to do what they can to help stop it, you know?
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Didn't start the fire, but sure trying to stop it.
That's some of the lyrics.
Started the fire.
I'm curious on what's gonna happen with A-Train. The one thing is, like, will he be kicked out then, or will he change it because of, like, what the news or the reporter or whatever lady said? But the other side of that, if he is kicked out, will he, like, where does he go? What does he do? Does he change the way he's thinking? Does he go after Vought and Homelander and stuff because he knows what they did and everything? Is that going to be, a loose thread that Homelander's going to try to kill later on? I don't know.
I think the other guy's name was Shockwave.
Yeah,
Shockwave.
I think.
Yeah, that's what Calvin said.
Yeah. I was trying to remember.
I wonder if he's also a Transformer.
That'd be awesome. It's Shockwave!
I loved every scene with Mother's Milk with MM. Like, the scene in the donut place or whatever with Starlight was awesome, but the motivation that his father had this disease of, like...
Justice,
basically. Yeah. One trying to do within the law, he's doing it without outside of the law, and he doesn't want it to happen to his kids.
Yeah.
Does it seem like he... Do you think he died of something natural, just pushing himself too much?
That's what I thought.
Or do you think that there's something more sinister there?
Because when he said, like, yeah, my dad just had a disease.
Mm-hmm. No, I don't mean that. I think the disease is about more of, like, his strive to take down Vought. Yes. Was, like, the disease. Yeah. And now Mother's Milk has worked on taking down Vought, and he doesn't want to pass it down to his kids who also see it. But he said about how he would be on that typewriter working when he went to bed, and he'd wake up, and he would still hear him hammering away on the typewriter. Like, did he run himself ragged and died because of not taking care of himself, trying to fight Vought?
Or was there a soup with fox dye power?
Well, yeah, in a way. Like, was there some kind of more sinister thing where, like, Vought killed him in some way or fashion?
Or do we find out that his head exploded, just like Mallory,
I feel like he would
and it turned
that.
Out to be Liberty? Yeah.
I don't
the
think
whole time, because she was living next door and she heard the typewriter clack-clacking all night.
No.
He said he found his body. I feel like he would remember if his head was exploded.
It's more ridiculous.
Well, he just said he was slumped over.
Yeah.
He didn't say slumped over.
He didn't say his head wasn't blown up.
You figured that would be the thing. Not slumped over. It'd be like he was sitting at his typewriter, no head. Like,
he said he was slumped over his typewriter.
Yeah, I feel like the head would be the thing you'd notice more than just being
slumped
over.
If you're trying to talk to somebody and get them to let you into their house, you don't talk about headless people. Seems like a threat.
He's right.
I don't want to say that.
let's see what people were saying over on Twitter. Because we've had a pretty good discussion so far, and I want to get their points of view in here.
If you guys want to join in on the discussion over Twitter, you can by using the hashtag TheBoysQ&A.
Logan, will you guys react to the short film?
Yep. Oh, yes, we will.
Imagine that's 90% of them.
Yeah, we didn't mention the discussion, but I love that he has, like, Frenchie's ringtone is just...
I thought it was Farazaka.
It was Farazaka.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what were you doing?
I think I was doing the
French
British National Anthem.
Neil McCadian says, Homelander aside, which superhero in the Boys universe do you think is the most powerful and dangerous?
Without Homelander?
I'm going to go...
I don't feel like I know enough about Black Noir to
Yeah, that's
know.
Why he's most dangerous, because you don't know.
Yeah. Like, I thought he was dead when he blew up, and he was fine.
Yeah.
He just had a couple little scuffs, you know? Like...
Yeah, but most dangerous, meaning, like, can cause the most damage. I definitely think that's Stormfront,
well,
right?
I don't know. I mean, what do you consider dangerous? Is it the media following Stormfront has? Is that the most dangerous? Is it that Black Noir can just sneak up behind you and just kill you out of nowhere? You didn't even know he was there? Because Stormfront, you probably would realize she was there, you know? Homelander, you probably would.
I mean, maybe.
He would
she
like,
can
you know.
Fly at, like, supersonic speed,
Yeah, but
too.
You feel the air changing, like, when a Stormfront comes in. I think Ryan is the most dangerous.
Who?
Ryan. That's holding
the
son, right?
Oh, yeah. The kid. Okay.
You're probably right.
I was thinking of superheroes, and I was like, he's not even here yet.
I don't think he's...
His...
I mean, he could be dangerous, I guess.
He has the potential.
You use the mom as some kind of catalyst.
No, I think the idea here would be, like, if you gave a 10-year-old a gun, is that dangerous?
Yes.
See? You have this kid who has powers. If he doesn't know how to use them, that's dangerous.
But the kid has the gun already.
Yeah.
And he doesn't play with it.
Just not loaded.
What? What do you mean he doesn't play with it? He's just carrying it around. He doesn't know what to do with it. Eventually, he's going to figure it out.
It's sitting in the corner of his room.
No, he has it on him all the time. You can't put it in the room because he always has his eyeballs.
The question was without Homelander, and you guys have settled on Homelander 2.0.
I would like Noir first.
Without Homelander, choose Homelander.
Although Stormfront, her media following and the way she was like, I don't have fans, I have soldiers, that can be pretty dangerous.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dip says, at the end, after dying, Doppelganger didn't change back. Do you think Homelander could use that body to fake his death someday? I don't know why he would fake his death, but that thought popped into my head.
Could be interesting.
I did think it was interesting that he didn't change back.
Well, I mean, it depends, I guess, how his powers work.
If it's a flex, some people when they die, they just freeze in that position that they're in,
They don't. They void their bowels. Everything relaxes.
Well, that probably happened too. But sometimes, I don't know.
He did say, it hurts so bad that I have to change back. Mm-hmm. So maybe it's a thing where, when he changes, that's what he is, and it starts to hurt. But since he's dead now, it doesn't hurt, so he just stays there. He has to physically, make it change.
Or maybe it's, an internal battery thing. An hour later, he'll change back.
If they did, a DNA analysis, would it be...
Homelander?
Homelander's DNA, or would it be...
Maybe that also has to do with, how does he change? Is it just as long as he sees him? Mm-hmm. Or, and how accurate is it? If I just saw a picture of someone's face, can I turn into them 100%?
Sure.
Or do you change your face?
What if my dick's the wrong length? How do I know? Or do I have to, how much information do I need?
Do you need to look at their dick?
I don't know, that's what I'm saying. What are the rules, Kyle? What are the rules?
What do you have, their birthmark?
Yeah, would I just know that?
I feel
do I know there's a birthmark on Calvin's ass? How do I get to that?
Change into this guy. Okay, but I need to see his dick.
I don't know.
I need to see it. Before I do anything, I just need to see his dick.
I'm going
to
say, at least half the time we've seen him changing someone, he's fucking someone, okay? You probably got to know some naked information, right?
Just make it a good length. Make it enjoyable.
Yeah, but that might...
That person's not going to know.
Too long, too short? You might be like, well, wait a minute. Wasn't as good last time, you know?
My experience, people like it short. So I went so long without talking. Okay, Mel says, I think it'd be interesting if you guys did your reactions for the boys with gallons of milk on the table. Let's get milk for next week. Also, how long before Homelander and Stormfront make an earthquake? I kind of felt that way towards the end, too, when she was like...
sexual tension?
Well, on her side, definitely.
She said, hey, my door is always open for anything. And he, snapped his head back, but he kept walking.
Yeah. I thought when she walked around him, maybe there was going to be, a kiss kind of moment thing. But I don't think you make the first move against Homelander.
And if that was a Smallville reference, then good job, Mel.
See, that's a scary thing, too. Homelander can make the first move, and he's like... You just do stuff and it's terrible. But if you make the first move, he doesn't want it. He just kills you, like the doppelganger guy. You know? He's gonna suck his dick. And he's like, nah!
Phoenix says, do you think any members of the Seven, like Deep, Queen Maeve, or A-Train, betrays Homelander, enjoys the boys in this season or in future seasons?
Is Deep still in the Seven?
He is. He hasn't been kicked out yet.
Officially, he is.
Still has a seat. They just sent him to Sandusky.
Yeah.
I could see the A-Train and the Queen Maeve.
Yeah, definitely those two.
Especially Homelander's
Starlight is already there.
Yeah, especially Homelander's little thing this time, pushing out, calling her out, saying Elena's name and stuff like that, too, where she was trying to keep secret.
Yeah.
That could be scary stuff now, but I don't know, maybe she stays with Homelander because she's worried about what he could do to her.
Do you think Huey could work with A-Train?
I don't know. Maybe. He
saved his life.
I don't think that anybody from the Seven other than Starlight would actually actively join the boys, but it might be one of those enemy of my enemy things.
Maybe.
G. Paul says, holy shit, this season has given me a sense of dread that I haven't felt since peak Game of Thrones. It feels like anyone could die at any moment, which is rare for a show, at least for me. Which characters are you worried for the most?
Starlight?
Yeah.
Becca.
Mm-hmm. Becca the most, I think.
You know, it'd be terrible if Becca died to the sun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And does Butcher kill him or raise him?
I could see the boys doing that for some reason, though. I could see that happening. I think Starlight is the one I'm most worried about. Yeah.
I think everybody but Homelander, maybe.
Maybe Maeve.
Maeve. Man, he just came out and outed her. Whenever he needed that information, he just kept in his back pocket and pulled it out whenever it served him.
Yep.
Wrong Number says, this felt like the Quiet Before the Storm episode, or Stormfront episode. Do you think Becca's confession confirms Homelander's rape, or is there a chance it was a consensual encounter? I think it confirms Homelander's rape.
I think so, too.
Like I said, the only other piece of it, like, you know, convincing for me the other way was, like, I don't see why Homelander would care enough to lie. But I could also see him just not realizing that not everybody loves him, which he'd realize in this episode. Alt Polo says, do you feel like Billy is heading to a really dark place? His story is starting to feel more like a supervillain origin story.
Heading.
He's always really been in the dark place, but yeah. Well,
I think it's going to lead to having to take down Vought in order to get Becca out.
Yeah.
Especially since, like, Vought won't stop after Ryan. So the only way to stop and be able to get Ryan and Becca out is to stop Vought.
Or I think the other way it could go is through Starlight and maybe Kumiko, that he learns to see not all soups are bad and learns to, like, actually love his son.
Her son.
Her son.
Yeah. I could see
that. He could adopt it. That could be cool.
It.
Him. And then Alt Polo's other question, is this show ruining milk for y'all too?
A little bit.
I mean,
although I can't have dairy right now anyway. So.
What ice cream?
Chocolate milk.
No dairy.
It's different.
I only use milk to torture others.
But cheese.
A little bit of cheese is okay.
That's dairy though.
About so. Jell-O pudding pops.
Is that dairy? Pudding, I guess, would be dairy, right?
I can't not think of Bill Cosby.
What?
No.
Like he was the spokesperson for Jell-O pudding pop.
You're just like all the time you thinking of Bill Cosby? Just the
pudding. Wait, Paul! All right, guys, poll this week. We are going to go with, if anybody currently in the Seven were to defect and join the boys to actively go against Vought, who is more likely or most likely to do that? Who do you pick?
A-Train.
So Homelander.
Yep.
Stormfront.
Yep. Maeve.
Starlight.
Starlight's in it.
Well, yes. Starlight is already defected.
Well, then she'll win the poll. Okay, we'll take Starlight out.
Starlight. A-Train.
Yep.
Black Noir.
Mm.
Maeve.
Stormfront.
And Maeve. I already said Stormfront.
Okay.
Who am I missing?
The Deep. Yeah. It's really going to be between, for me, Maeve, Deep, and A-Train.
I think Deep's got his own thing going. He still wants back Deep, in the Seven desperately.
Yeah.
A-Train.
I'm going to
say Maeve.
Maeve.
And
so no one is thinking Homelander, Stormfront, or Black Noir?
I'll go Black Noir. You never Black know Noir? With that guy.
I have no idea.
We have no idea.
It could be a girl.
He could take his mask off and join the boys and they'd never fucking
Dude,
know.
Dude, what would it be crazy if he took his mask off like, and his fucking Carl Urban? I'm going to see me the same time.
It'd be great if it was Frenchie.
Fucking cuts.
No, because they fought in the alleyway that one time, right?
No, Butcher wasn't there. That was Kumiko and Frenchie.
They were the only ones there?
Yeah.
I don't know.
She ran off. Frenchie went after her. And then she got stabbed. And then he left.
He's hunting down Butcher.
Yeah, I know, but we don't know.
That would be a great way of trying to get around it, right?
Thank you guys for watching this episode of The Boys. You can catch the next one next week because we're doing it live.
Live!
Subscribe so you don't miss a reaction. Also, you can check out patreon.com/flyaway for full length early access to our non-live shows and more.
Live!
Bye.
Live.